It's all kinds of chest pain, and we see this every day. It's one of the biggest features that enters the emergency department, and also one of the most frequent complaints that we have in people coming to get a cardiology consultation. It occurs from various issues. It can occur certainly from cardiac pain, but it can also occur from musculoskeletal discomfort from prior injury. It can be associated with pulled muscles or sore muscles from coughing. Sometimes coughs can be violent enough in the flu season, for instance, or with a bad bronchitis, that they can actually cause costochondritis, which is pain in the at the junction of the rib and the cartilaginous portion of the rib or sternum. But the most important characteristic of cardiac pain is the fact that it occurs with exertion and in a crescendo manner, and then goes away in a decrescendo manner when the exertion stops. It tends to get worse over time. Over the space of a week or two, it will get worse. Now, the pain of a myocardial infarction or a heart attack tends to be much more severe than that, but it still has the crescendo flavor to it, and it tends to be more oppressive. It may be associated with shortness of breath, and it may be associated with sweating, for instance, and a general really impending feeling of doom. The best strategy actually is to call your physician and talk about the pain with him. But certainly if the pain is fairly sudden, not horribly severe, has a pleuritic nature to it, in other words, increases and decreases with respiration and so forth, then there's really little reason to run off to an emergency room. If it's associated with some other symptom, such as sweating or shortness of breath, or gets worse when you lie down, then sure, that needs to be presented to an emergency room. Well, that's a tough one, because one can have cardiac discomfort that seems very much like esophageal reflux. There's a burning quality to cardiac pain sometimes. Reflux, of course, can come on in a crescendo manner. It gets worse when you lay down. So that sometimes is a little bit confusing and requires some further evaluation. And it's very common. If, on the other hand, it promptly goes away when a person takes an antacid, that would be very non-typical for cardiac pain. So sometimes people have already tried these remedies, and sometimes people have not. Any discomfort that has that crescendo flavor to it is vague in location, is truly uncomfortable, gets worse when they lie down, for instance, unassociated with changes in respiration, and especially if they have risk factors of high blood pressure, high cholesterol, or a family history, or if they've had a prior cardiac event, those people ought to be a little bit more willing to come and discuss it with a professional. We see people in their early 30s who have coronary artery disease. Now, it's vastly more uncommon than it is to see them in their 50s and 60s have events. But nonetheless, it does occur. In people with any risk in their family, I think they probably ought to at least get a blood test, check their blood pressure, and perhaps do that on a yearly basis, or maybe every other year if it's a lower risk. Certainly diabetics and young people who have already been diagnosed as hypertension, they should definitely be under the care of a physician.